In Creo Parametric, the two primary commands that you use to make changes to a model are edit, also known as edit dimensions, and edit definition. Let's take a look at how to use these. Here I have a part model open. One way that you can get to the commands is by clicking on a feature in the model tree. And when I left click on this feature, we get a mini toolbar. And the very first two commands in the mini toolbar are edit, also known as edit dimensions, and edit definition. Let's take a look at the differences between these two commands. When I click on the edit dimensions command, we get all the different dimensions associated with the feature displayed in the graphics area. Let me double click on a dimension to change it, and I'll punch in a new value. Let's change this from 133 to 160, and then hit the enter key. The dimension is still selected, and it will open up the dimension tab that allows you to make changes to the dimension, including stuff like adding additional dimension text or changing the formatting. I'm going to left click on the background of the screen. That is going to close the dimension tab. And then I will double click in order to get out of the edit dimensions mode. And that also automatically regenerates the model, which means it rebuilds the different features in the tree in the order in which they appear. And so edit, also known as edit dimensions, allows you to change the different dimensions associated with the feature. Another way of getting to the edit command is to double click on geometry in the graphics area. And here I have a dimension for the diameter. Let's double click on it. I will change it from a value of 22 to 18. And once again, I will left click to deselect it. And then I can double click in order to regenerate the model. You can manually regenerate the model by using the regenerate command, which is also the keyboard shortcut of Control G. And you might be asking, hey, why is it Control G and not Control R? Well, Control R is for repainting the screen. Now let's take a look at edit definition. Edit definition is a virtual recreate for your different features. For example, let me locate the hole for this pattern. And then I will use edit definition, which by the way is the keyboard shortcut of Control E. And when I do that, it's going to open up the original dashboard that was used to create the feature. Also, we have the different dimensions associated with the feature in the graphics area, plus the different drag handles for changing it. And if you hold down the right mouse button, you will get the asynchronous menu, as the right mouse button menus are known as well as the mini toolbar. And so from here, I can change this hole. Maybe I'm going to change the depth from through all to next. Won't actually change the hole, but I am making a change to the definition of it. Now let's also do things like I can say, hey, this diameter may be a little bit too big. Let's change it from 10 to a value of 8. And then when I am finished making my changes with edit definition, you can hit the check mark or the middle mouse button, which is the same thing as the check mark. Let's take a look at another example here. So for example, we have the pattern of the different holes. If I go to the edit or edit dimensions command, here we have the different dimensions for the pattern. So I could change the number of instances from 8 to 6. And then I can left click to deselect everything. And then I can left click in the graphics area in order to update the model. If I select that same pattern and then go to edit definition, here we get the dashboard for the pattern feature. We've got all our different tabs available and the dimensions available on the screen as well. That's good. Let's hit the check mark in order to get out of edit definition. Let's take a look at these same commands in an assembly model. Now I am in an assembly that contains that component. Let me select that component in the model tree. And here I have the edit command and edit dimensions. Let's go to edit dimensions first. And you can see that this particular component has a numerical value associated with locating it. Let me double click on the dimension and I'm going to change it to a much bigger value. Let's change that to 200. Once again, I will left click to deselect the dimension. And now I will use the keyboard shortcut of Control G to update the model, and the component is repositioned. Not all components will have dimensions associated with them. For example, if I click on some of the components here, you'll notice that there is no edit dimensions command available from the mini toolbar, because if I go to edit definition, well, this brings up the component placement tab that defines how this was located. And we have one coincident constraint. There are no dimensions associated with that. And another coincident constraint. So there are no dimensions associated with how this is located in our model. Similarly, if I go back to that very first component, and this time I will select it out of the graphics area and then go to edit definition, we're going to get the component placement dashboard that defines how this component is located in the model. Let's cancel out of there. And also, if you want to make changes to a particular part when you are in the assembly, one way that you can do that is by selecting the component and then using the activate command. If you take a look in the lower left-hand corner of the graphics area, it tells us the name of the active part. And when we take a look at the part in the model tree, it's got a little green diamond located on the symbol for the component. If I expand this in here, I've got all the different features, and I could say, hey, let's select this feature, and maybe I want to edit its definition. And here we have a revolve feature that we can change and get into the sketch and do whatever we want to it. So when you activate a component, it's like opening up that component in its own separate window, but you're working on it in the context of the assembly. When you activate a component and you no longer want it activated, if you want to go back to the top level assembly, you can do that by selecting the top node in the model tree and then using the activate command. Also, Control A will also activate the top level of the assembly again. You'll notice that there's no message in the graphics area telling us what the active part is. And be aware, even without activating a part, you can make changes to different features. So once more, I can go to this protrusion, and when I left click on it, I get the mini toolbar. And from here, I can use the edit command. And here's that length. It's a value of 160. Hey, let's change it one more time. Let's change it to a value of 180. And then I can regenerate using the little icon in the status bar. And that way we have made a change to the length of that feature in the assembly, even though we didn't activate the part. So again, just remember, the edit dimensions command in part mode will allow you to change the dimensions of a feature. Edit definition allows you to change everything about a feature, including its references, its dimensions. If it has a sketch, you can change that, all your different options and attributes. When you are in an assembly, the edit command allows you to change any dimensions associated with the constraints that locate the component in the assembly, and edit definition brings open the component placement dashboard that allows you to change the different constraints that locate the component in the model. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you learned something from this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you like this video, please click the subscribe button and ring the bell to be informed when new videos are uploaded. Thank you very much.